our child became a bully today. And I'll tell you how it happened. Last week, our son came running into the house. He was crying. He was sobbing. He could hardly breathe. When he caught his breath, he told us that a group of kids had surrounded him in the neighborhood. They were mocking him because he couldn't do tricks on his bike. They were telling him how bad he was and how much they hated him. He was scared. He was humiliated. Now, we tried to talk to the parents, but that didn't go so well. So we told them the only thing we knew to do, don't play with those kids. Stay away from them. And we thought it was done. But then today, this happened. Another parent came to us and said that our son was bullying another kid. I mean, what the heck? But it was true. But why would our son inflict the same hurt and pain on another kid that he had experienced himself? Well, I'll tell you why. See, when kids have experienced something traumatic, they will think through that event over and over and over because they're trying to understand something that is beyond their comprehension. They will think questions like, why did this happen? Why did they do that? What did I do wrong? And when they can't find the answers to those questions, they will recreate that event because they want to understand what happened and because they want to get rid of the emotional pain that they have been carrying around. Now, that story wasn't really about my son, but see, what I tell parents who tell me stories like that is that your kids do not have to keep replaying and recreating those same hurtful events if you can do this one thing with them. And it's called an empathy talk. And an empathy talk is very important because it allows your child to become unstuck. It allows them to move past that moment and put it behind them, to be able to heal from it. So here's how you have an empathy talk. You gotta listen to your kid. You gotta help them connect their emotion to their words, to their experience. You gotta talk with them about, wow, that must have been so frightening when you were surrounded by those kids. You must have been so embarrassed by what they were saying. You must have felt so angry by their words. You know, whatever it is, you want to listen to what their experience is and help them label those emotions. Repeat it back to them. When you do that, not only do they feel heard by you, not only do they feel connected by you, but they start to make sense of it. They say, yeah, I was really scared. Yeah, I was really angry. Yeah, I was really embarrassed. They're starting to understand what happened. And then you let them know that they're not alone. You know, a great way to do that is to say, you know, any kid, any person in that situation would have been scared. Anyone in that situation would have been embarrassed. Anyone would have had that kind of anger or felt that kind of hurt. You're not alone. This is not unique to you. This is something that everyone experiences when they're in situations like that. And then you help them turn the empathy onto other people. And you have these conversations, you say, you know, you have the opportunity to influence how other people feel as well. And you know what it feels like to be trapped. You know what it feels like to be humiliated. You know what it feels like to be teased, made fun of, to be the brunt of jokes. You know what that feels like. And you can keep other people from feeling that way because you don't have to do the same thing to them. Because that's how they felt. Now you understand what happened to you, and you don't have to do that with anyone else. You're helping them understand. You're helping them understand they're not alone, and you're helping them understand and learn that they don't have to repeat that with other people. It's a very powerful conversation. You might have to do it many times with your child because, again, really, they're trying to understand. The younger they are, the more they need you to help them with that conversation because you're basically, you're being their brain, you know, because their brain isn't developed. So you're helping them connect in the way that an adult would, but in a child's brain. And that helps them build resiliency. That helps them build skills. They learn how to do this for themselves over time. Like it's very painful. There's just about nothing worse than seeing your child suffer and going through something traumatic. But the way you talk with them really does help them out. So what I encourage you, along with any other parent, is don't ignore those moments when your kids have gone through something traumatic. Talk it through with them. Do it in the way that I was describing to you, because that really does help them understand, make sense of it, so they don't have to carry it around and be stuck. Hey, I hope that helped you out. And tune back in, because there's going to be some other videos to help you out with your kids when they're going through some difficult situations. I will talk to you soon.